My name is Jonathan Jones, and I am a best-selling author. I am a TEDx speaker, as well as podcast host. I would just label myself as an individual who enjoys encouraging and empowering other students and millennials to pursue their passions. I realized that me writing a book would allow me to create more opportunity for myself, as well as encourage other people to pursue their passions as well. When I first had the idea and the concept for the book, it wasn't necessarily driven towards entrepreneurs. But then as I went back and I read it a couple of times myself, then I began to realize that these 14 behaviors apply to millennials, but even outside of the millennial population. Because it's a self-help book and it causes you to self-reflect, and it directly applies to whomever. I talk about being forgiving. I talk about being thankful. I talk about being faithful, and those are things that can apply to any area of your life, if you're an entrepreneur or if you're not. Millennials are the generation that gets beat up. The millennials are the generation that gets talked down upon, but I believe that we're one of the most impactful as well as one of the most educated generations. So I specifically wanted to write the book to encourage and empower this generation, because there's so much potential within our generation and there's so much passion, and I wanted to write this book to help us identify that passion and then ultimately use our energy and use our gifts to create the life and business that we desire for ourselves.
This morning I woke up and I was a lion. I was a lion because I knew I was gonna get the opportunity to talk to y'all. And when you get to that point, that's what that passion looks like, because you're excited about doing something. You're driven by doing something.
800 kids, they filled up the arena at SMU, and it was entitled The Power of Commitment. Because I believe strongly that if we're not committed to something greater than ourselves, then we'll quit every time, because it's easy. Because if we don't feel like working out, like, tomorrow, maybe. If we don't feel like getting up and going to work, we'll call in. But then if we realize that if I don't go to work, then my niece, my nephew, those kids that look up to me, then they'll have an excuse and they'll think it's okay for them to do the same thing. A perfect or an ideal place for me to speak would be to millennials or those managing millennials, just to help them bridge the gap. Because I know there has been some friction, and I believe there currently still is some in the work climate or the workforce. So just helping bridge gaps and ultimately seeing that we can all collaborate and work together so that everybody wins. Somebody older than you can always learn something from somebody younger than you, as well as vice versa. So we might as well just allow our weaknesses to be our weaknesses, but then allow them to be strengthened by somebody who is better in that area.
I just want you to understand that whatever your definition of success is, it's just that. It's all yours. No one can tell you, no, that's irrelevant. No. You need to strive for more. Because once you identify what success looks like for you, then you strive towards it.
My podcast started out being entrepreneurial. Then I said, you know what, I want to shift it, because life's about more than just business. The greatest part, or the best part about being me and doing what I do, is allowing others to find something deeper within themselves, and then the light bulb going off, and then by them finding their truth and them finding their purpose, and ultimately they help somebody find theirs. I want to add value regarding the self-help strategies, providing motivation, in addition to giving life application, because I want people to have some ready to use, tangible either instruction or step that they can take time in to really reflect and then to see the value from it in their own lives.